The stable version 7.1.8 does not have as many changes as 7.1.7, but there are some important ones. The biggest news is that IP version 6 can finally support FastPath and FastTrack. It has been a long time coming, but now you can get the same kind of performance with IP version 6 as you have been getting with IP version 4. Then there is another awesome change that now seems so fundamental that it is almost crazy that we did not have it this whole time. When you go to the System Packages section and check for updates, you will find that every single extra package that you could install on your device will show up as not installed. If you would like to add any one of them, simply set it to enabled and will automatically get downloaded and scheduled for an installation. Once you have rebooted your device, you will have the new package. Next, there have been several changes to the container package. First up, the registry URL that you use to download remote images is now set to lscr.io by default. It belongs to linuxserver.io, which is an alternative to the Docker Hub. You can change the default setting if you want, but you could also just override the default whenever you're adding a new remote image. This should make adding images from various online sources a lot easier. A more needed container improvement is that now the root directory location is used not only for the installation, but also for unpacking the image. So it will be less likely that you fail to unpack an image because you ran out of space. The container package is now also capable of detecting the board's architecture to a higher degree. Previously, it could not tell the difference between ARM version 6 and ARM version 5. This resulted in the unfortunate situation where the hex refresh would fail to add containers properly, as it is the older architecture type. Now, there are not that many containers that are designed for version 5 on the container registries, but the important thing is that containerization is now fixed for the new hex and any other products we might make with the same CPU. A common issue with containers is the RAM requirement. So the swap file feature was initially added with the container package, but with this update, it got moved to the base package because there are other foreseeable situations where people could use more RAM but cannot add the container package. The file management side of RouterOS is getting some improvements, mainly to better deal with large amounts of files and to allow better features in the future. If you're curious, you can now print the file contents of specific directories, and you also have the optional recursive and relative flags available when doing so. Recursive simply checks the contents of any subdirectories, while the relative flag will hide the hierarchy above the current directory. The ROS package now provides full BTRFS support. Besides a new option when formatting disks, you also get a separate BTRFS section. There you get the BTRFS file system overview along with the scrub and balance features. You also have a subvolume section where you can add new subvolumes, including snapshots. And you also have a section where you can transfer your subvolumes over the network. Some people have really been waiting for hardware offloaded VXLAN, and it's here. All our latest CRS and CCR series devices have switch chips that are capable of providing this feature. If you have any doubts, just check with the device tables on our help page. The default port for VXLAN has also been changed to 4789. ARM and ARM64 devices now have a new package available called IoT BT Extra. It adds support for generic Bluetooth adapters that support Bluetooth low energy and Bluetooth advertising. So now you can turn many of our switches and routers into Bluetooth tracking devices. And you are not even limited to Bluetooth tags manufactured by us. You could use third-party tags too. As long as your dongle works with our device and your tags work with your dongle, you are good to go. We do not provide a supported device list, but if you find that you are having problems with a dongle that is Bluetooth 4 or above, feel free to contact our support. The last change worthy of mention is that devices capable of layer 3 hardware offloading now have advanced settings and monitoring available from the GUI. I don't have it running there, but you get the idea. Keep your devices updated, and I will see you next time.